Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for my journey. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. You for my journey. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Over hills and through the valleys, oh Lord, you brought me. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Over hills and through the valleys, oh Lord, you brought me. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Oh yeah, here we go. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for my journey. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. You for my journey. For you brought me from a mighty long way. You said do this. Oh Lord, I cried and I cried, but then you brought me. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Lord, I cried and I cried, but then you brought me. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Oh yeah. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for my journey. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. You for my journey. For you brought me from a mighty long way. For you brought me from a mighty long way. For you brought me from a mighty long way. Way. Yeah. Thanks, guys. What kind of man is this? Walks like Jesus. What kind of man is this? Talks like Jesus. What kind of man is this? He looks like Jesus. Oh, 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 must be the Lord. What kind of man is this? Come from Galilee. What kind of man is this? Calm the raging sea. What kind of man is this? Who died for you and me? Oh, 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 must be the Lord. Must be the Lord, must be the Lord, must be the Lord, yeah, must be the Lord.
Yeah. What kind of man is this? What kind of man is this? Oh, 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 oh. Must be the Lord. Must be the Lord. Yeah, must be the Lord. Yeah, must be the Lord. What kind of man is this? What kind of man is this? Oh, 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 oh. Must be the Lord. What kind of man is this? When I'm lonely, what kind of man is this? When I'm calling, what kind of man is this? Who hears me when I call? Oh, 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 must be the Lord.
Yeah, you want to do it? Yeah.
Oh.
Wow, what a crowd, eh?
One more river to cross, one more mountain to climb, one more valley that I gotta go through, leaving my troubles behind. One more battle with the devil, and I know he'll understand. I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah. I hold to my nail scarred hands, hold to his nail scarred hands.
Well, I had a lot of troubles and trials in my little lifespan. And when I'm standing alone and the battle is hot, I always do the best that I can. I had to climb a lot of high mountains and across a lot of little streams. But when I get to the river of Jordan, hallelujah, there will be no fears. Whoa, I will have no fears. I got one more river to cross, one more mountain to climb, one more valley that I gotta go through, leaving my troubles behind. One more battle with the devil, and I know he'll understand. I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah. Holding to his nail-scarred hands, holding to his nail-scarred hands.
I had a lot of people talking about me since I walked this narrow way. There is just another little river, I come through it when I pray. But I climbed a lot of high mountains and I crossed a lot of little streams. But when I get to the Jordan, cold and dark, that'll be the last for me. Whoa, that'll be the last for me. I got one more river to cross, one more mountain to climb, one more valley that I gotta go through, leaving my troubles behind. One more battle with the devil, and I know he'll understand. I'm going through with Jesus, hallelujah. A hold to his nail scarred hands,
to his nail scarred
hands.
Hold it to his nail scarred,
hold to his nail scarred hands. Hold him to his nail scarred.
to his nail-scarred hands. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Gotis.
And I was going to begin so reflective, so, so serious. After 37 years of rehearsals, it's time to do the real thing, huh? Good morning, church. I welcome you. I welcome you to this amazing and rich time of worship in the Spirit and the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, our friend. I'm soon to be retired, Steve Gotis. It's a privilege, a joy to welcome you to this day of worship and retirement hijinks. The word jumped out at me as I got the greeting card some time ago. I kept the card. The word is an old English slang term, coddawumple. Coddawumple. There it is right there. Its definition captured my attention. Coddawumple. To travel purposefully toward an as yet unknown destination. To travel purposefully to an as of yet unknown destination. To say that I'm about to coddawimple is an understatement. To say that you, God's people, are about to coddawimple is as well. God's presence in our lives as we gather here this Sunday in the light of Epiphany is the Lord guiding us purposefully to those yet to unknown destinations to which we're called. So as this service is about to begin, are you ready to coddawimple?
Yeah.
CMC, Christ Moravian Church, has always taken its time of greeting very seriously and very personally. It builds fellowship. It grows relationships. It reminds us of the love that shapes us. It's offered from one heart to another. First of all, I want to specifically greet our first-time worshipers, if there are any joining us this very special Sunday. I'd be remiss if I didn't welcome others of note. Our son Daniel, his wife Alicia, grandchildren Ben and Calvin and Margot. Glad you're here. My siblings, that you've heard so many stories about, all the good ones, my brother Keith and his wife Mary, my sister Kathleen, we call her Kai, and Melanie. So delighted and so touched that you'd take the time to come and take part in this week. As well, joining us today, our daughter Kari, husband Vince is up running the live stream, offering this service to the many viewers, worshipers at home, and their two children, Veronica and Matilda. I know there are many other special friends here that I can't specifically greet or acknowledge at this time, but maybe later on in the day. At Christ Moravian Church, the most recent greeting that has been embraced as we've come together beyond the COVID experience is building a heart with our hands, peering through that heart, knowing the love of my heart, shared and showered on another. Please rise, share this greeting with one another. Have a seat, everyone. The light from a simple candle can begin to change our world, I believe. A candle that invites a prayer of peace, a word of confession, a kind thought for a friend who would be in need. It begins to make those changes, those movements of love found in Christ's presence. I've invited my two sisters, Kai and Melanie, to light our candles of peace. Pause in prayer for a moment. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. Our worship end right.
Lily of the valley, let your sweet aroma fill my life. Rose of Sharon, show me how to grow in beauty in God's light. Fairest of 10,000, make me a reminder of your light, of your light. Day stars shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Lead me, Lord, I follow. Anywhere you open up the door. Let your word speak to me, show me what I've never seen before. Lord, I want to be a witness. You can take what's wrong and make it right. Day stars shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Lord, I see a world that's dying, wounded by the master of deceit. Searching in the darkness, haunted by the years of past defeat. But then I see you standing near me, Lord, shining with compassion in your eyes, in your eyes. And I say, Jesus, shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Lead me, Lord, I follow. Anywhere you open up the door. Let your word speak to me. Show me what I've never seen before. Lord, I want to be a witness. You can take what's wrong and make it right. Day stars shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Day stars shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Jesus, shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night.
Thank you, Marty. Thank you, ladies. You're making me cry already. Please rise for a call to worship, if able. Jesus invites us through whispers, words, and silence, saying, come, follow me.
In our words, new beginnings of faith, our journey begins to cumbrous and winding road.
God names each one, saying, you are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. You're the sheep of my pasture.
We gather together in faith to rediscover the gifts that God has bestowed in all of us.
Christ even pauses to invite the child, the leper, the broken, the sinful, the grieved, and the lost to know the love that God offers with abundance. Let us thank and worship the God of this creation.
Let us gather in the light of Christ's love. Amen.
And let's sing. January 14th, 1996, we sang that song. That was my installation Sunday here 27 years ago. Do you remember that song? Let's move on and share together a litany, a prayerful thought as the light of the Epiphany guides us forward. As we discover in the biblical stories, our lives are like a journey. It's a road that began with our birth, that winds its way through meadows and mountaintops, that crosses rivers and barren deserts. Gracious God.
For the
We pray for those whose journey ends, whose journey ends seems to be too short, or those whose journey detours beyond our understanding.
We pray for those
We pray for those whose path seems continually to face switchbacks that are insurmountable, facing issues such as poverty, hunger, pain, illness, violence, and more.
We pray in times of world concern, when the issues of famine, war, natural disaster, or global anxiousness seem to lead us to dead ends.
In the landscape of your abounding love, we know there are pathways leading to the promised still and refreshing waters. There are days ahead when all your children shall walk with hope and peace upon a green and fruitful earth.
Untroubled by war, want, loneliness, or uselessness.
Let us build a broad highway where all may walk together in beauty, peace, and hope. All these things we pray in the partnership and saving grace of Jesus Christ, the morning star of our faith.
We pray with confident joy as Jesus holds our hands as a friend. Amen.
Over these 27 years at Christ Moravian Church, I've come to really appreciate this next song, the music written by Doug McKercher, the lyrics by Reverend Dr. Glenn Stout, my predecessor. Let's stand, let's sing together.
Actually, we're going to play it through once, just because it may not be really familiar. Okay? And then Dora will lead us once we start singing.
Okay.
Folks at CMC love it. They love it when I switch to the Garth Brooks mic, because I might go into a song like Rodeo. They know that, don't they? Gonna invite the young folks, because it's a special occasion, some special things are happening. If you have an offering, you're gonna be invited to come on down. And at CMC here, when I first arrived, there was one offering piggy. The church was broken into, it was stolen, and the next little piggy was the skinny leg pig. And after that, I've come to realize pigs reproduce. And let's grab some chairs. Here is my favoritest pig, the pile of pigs, so representative of the church, where we pile up together and share together. I want you to make sure you can see the screen over here. All right, make sure you can see the screen, because our children's message is a video. Heidi, you want to grab some more of the stools and bring over here for Sarah, Daniel, and gang here? Thank you. All right. And you are really loading that up, huh? Oh, we got lots more. You know, we take stocks and bonds too, you know. What else you got, Ben? Oh, Tilly's got more. Well, God's blessings, and now you, she's got even more. Thank you, Tilly. Okay, have a seat now. And as many of us know, this special offering supports now two of our students at the Moravian Institute in Rajpur, India, and sis. Oh, we got more down here. Jasper, here's. And God bless this. I wanted to highlight, I counted 42 pigs yesterday. Jake Wolf counted 38. One of us is not, and then I came in today, it's like, there's 41. So one of the pigs is out there somewhere. But this is the world's tiniest little piggy. It's got a penny, barely able to get in there. Look at that. Have you ever seen such a small piggy bank? Huh? That arrived in the garage sale about 15 years ago. Yeah. These are the kind of things you discover over a few years of ministry life. So, and I wanted to highlight my siblings. We all took part in 4-H and having a farm, showing cattle and hogs. That cane over there, the crook, the shepherd's crook, we would have used that to show hogs at the county fair bygone day. And my dad gave that to me before he passed away. We think it came from some weird auction sale that he attended and was shared with me. And CMC folks know what a wonderful symbol that is for the life of the church. A shepherding experience as a pasture welcomes us and the still waters, green pastures are part of that experience. A few years ago, we went through this thing called COVID, huh? And many of us were sheltered, cautious. The congregation here was active, very active. And I'll treasure that as one of the most fulfilling times of ministry in the way in which there are partnerships and the sharing of ministry to support the needs of our community in so many ways. And worship-wise, we began sharing worship videos each week. And early in the experience, we began to have these things called Some Good News. And a lot of our young folks took part and had roles in Some Good News. So we have a one last episode put together for this special occasion of Some Good News. Let's hit it, tech team.
welcome to CMC Some Good News. CMC Some Good News. Wait, why is that in there twice? Cut, cut. Can I get the script team in here? Who wrote this thing? Oh, did they let Gonis back on the writing team again? That guy should really think about retiring. Oh, was that? I'm supposed to say it twice? Okay, okay, I get it. Let's try that again.
Action.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to CMC Some Good News, CMC Some Good News Edition. I'm Olivia. You've likely been losing sleep not knowing how CMC Some Good News got started. Well, after this episode, you'll rest easy. We're going to interview the man with the master plan, the genius who came up with the concept of CMC Some Good News, Pastor Steve. But first, let's go to Levi for a weather report. Levi, how's the weather out there? Thanks, Levi. Before we get to our main story, here's a few clips from our Christmas caroling event from December 20th, 2023.
Silent night.
Let's do it again next year. Now, let's go to our feature interview. Over to you, Clara.
Thanks, Olivia. I'm here with Pastor Steve Gotis, the originator of the CMC Some Good News idea. Hey, Steve, nice sweater.
You know, you notice there's no splatter on my sweater, nor is there any wax on my slacks, and I know no dress has got messes during Christmas Eve this year. We're so grateful for the swag of CMC. It's selling. It's selling fast and furious.
Amazing. So back to some good news.
Oh yeah, some good news.
Some good news. So how did it all begin? And why do you think we needed CMC Some Good News?
So going back to, I think it was in May of 2020, several months of COVID-19 had already begun occurring. And our congregation had already moved to having digitally prepared worship services, Steve Blackwell editing them, allowing them to be viewed week by week by a congregation. And knowing that I personally, and I think everybody, was gravitating toward anything hopeful, anything that put a smile on your face or gave you a sense of calm or a giggle. A friend of ours suggested Heidi and I watch this thing, John Krasinski, the guy from The Office, was putting together a little episodes of Some Good News, and they were off the wall, and they're funny, and they're imaginative and creative. And as Heidi and I watched, we said to ourselves, we can do that. And my first phone call was to Jessica Pratt, and I said, Jessica, what do you think? Can we prepare some episodes of Some Good News from Christ Church? And she said, yes, we can do that. And she volunteered her family to get it done. And along with an array of congregational members or friends of the church, episodes that found one of the most memorable is when the Pratt family went to Banff for a day outing, and they ran into the young lady that rang the bells of Banff and offered that music in the town of Banff as a very creative expression of care and kindness and joy. So anyhow, that's what sort of triggered this event, and I think it was still, as I chat with CMC folks or friends that have known about our episodes of worship
the Some Good News episodes were some of the most memorable things of what those services include. So that's the short answer of a very long question.
Well, on behalf of my family, thank you for giving us a cool project to keep us busy during some pretty boring times. Before we go, do you have some good news to offer our viewers?
I absolutely, yes. This sense of change and transition in my life, I walk into it with full gratitude and thanks for God's presence in the walk of my life, and as well that opportunity to meet with, share with, in partnership and friendship so many folks in the life of Christ Moravian Church, the Moravian Church, or the communities of life that Heidi and I and our kids have walked in. So some of the good news that I continue to share is seeing the good news found in each and every one that I meet. God blesses each of us to be a communicator of good news of great joy found in Jesus Christ. And additionally, good news is found in the life of Christ Moravian Church that is filled with folks prepared and ready and called to serve and support the life of this community of faith. I can't imagine the gifts that are found in so many different folks that we might see around the corner showing up to support the church's life.
Time we have for today, folks, but before we go, we head back to the CMC Some Good News archive for some evidence of why Steve felt the need to retire. A call back to the motherland, perhaps? Toodaloo!
We know that the Pratt family are watching from California as they conclude in a day or two their holiday, their vacation after Christmas. We thank them for all the retirement hijinks of that. And having my siblings here, I have no doubt my dad would think that was not right for church. So that was some good news, and each of us, each of you, continue to share good news in your own special way, bringing joy and happiness and love to each that you meet. Let's pray together the Lord's Prayer as a congregation. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Young folks are staying up here through the service. We'll keep it short and sweet. Back to your seats. Several other folks, clergy leaders, are here with me today, and as we were moving into ministry, we didn't really know what ministry was until it started to occur through what we began to experience. I have no doubt for all of us, when you go into it, what is this strange and special concept out there? Ministry is love. Ministry is people. Ministry is kindness and generous support. Ministry is making a difference where you go. And yes, ministry is money, funds, donations, love offerings that support an amazing church like Christ Moravian Church or another home church you take part in. Over these years, I've seen in this church and beyond the miraculous thing occur because of ministry that is supported in this fashion. It's time for our morning offering. Daniel.
Yes, there's a rainbow at the end of every storm. When troubles and trials stand in your way, when you get weary, too weary to pray, look to the sky, reach for his arms. Yes, there's a rainbow at the end of every storm. Whether it's sickness, whether it's death, with your heart grows heavy, can't find peace or rest. When clouds of doubt all around you fall, yes, there's a rainbow at the end of every storm. And his name is Jesus. Wonderful Savior, wonderful friend, Jesus. In the beginning, the middle, the end, he'll be there
to help,
to keep,
to save,
to keep you from every harm. Yes, there's a rainbow at the end of every storm. And his name is Jesus. Wonderful Savior, wonderful friend, Jesus. in the beginning, the middle, the end. He'll be there
to save,
to keep you from every harm. Yes, there's a rainbow at the end of every storm. Oh, and his name is Jesus. Wonderful Savior, wonderful friend, Jesus. In the beginning, the middle, the end, he'll be there to save and keep you from every harm. Yes, there's a rainbow at the end of every storm. Yes, there's a rainbow at the end of every storm.
Please rise. And we pray. Loving and caring God, acting with divine hope through the birth of Christ and sharing the light of grace and love in so many ways, shine with peace and transforming love through these gifts and offerings and the ministry they support. For the gift of this day and the many gifts we experience, we say thanks and we dedicate these gifts in the Spirit and the name of the Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And have a seat. I've taken some pastoral privileges through this worship service today, and watching the Christmas service from my son's church in just south of Chicago, Illinois, in Indiana, they had a special scripture reader that Sunday, and I've invited him to share the first reading of the day, Benjamin Godis.
All right.
Second Corinthians chapter 5, verses 16 to 20. So from now on we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone. The new is here. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as through God we're making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God.
And there were some $10 words in there, weren't there? Thank you, Benjamin. I know our parents, as we were growing up, took great pride in not only seeing us, the children, mature and grow up, but the grandchildren, and now greats. We can picture it in our own experience. Long before our time, there were the divine insights that God would be immersed into all times, all seasons, all retirements or comings and goings of life, yours and mine alike. And these insights became words of faith. They would resonate with us even beyond a text, almost like a melody that would be repeated as we live and experience. Ecclesiastes 3. There's a time for everything, a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. God has made everything beautiful in its time.
To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to reap, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to laugh, a time to weep. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to love, a time to hate. A time of war, a time of peace. A time that you may embrace. A time to refrain from embracing. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven.
I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its skies may turn to gray. I don't worry over the future, for I know Jesus said, and today I'll walk beside him, for he knows what is ahead.
Many tomorrow, and I know
Church, music and excellence in music has been a real hallmark of this church's life, and it will continue, I have no doubt. Thank you, Marty and ladies, and thanks, Marty, for taking us back to the 60s a little bit. The Birds, I used to drive tractor to that song, I think, back home. Seems appropriate for me. You're going to be here a little bit longer than I'd anticipated and hoped. Somehow some extra things got inserted here, but wanted to walk you through the 37 years of this ministry life that has been a privilege to share for myself, our family. After early years, they were interspersed with a variety of healthy, positive, good church experiences, faith activities as a child, back at our home church, Canaan Moravian Church in rural Davenport, North Dakota, at camps, retreats, youth activities, and Sunday school. It became evident in the January of 1979 that unmistakable sense of call into ministry emerged within my soul. Telling my father, I was leaving the farm. That was the most challenging thing I'd done up to that point in my life. But the support of him, my mother, siblings, aunts and uncles, lots of really understanding church members that knew me back home, I moved on to the journey of ministry. Following 4 years of undergrad studies at Moravian College, 3 years of seminary at Moravian Theological Seminary, I received my first call to serve the Glenwood Moravian Church in Madison, Wisconsin, and we're privileged to have Reverend Jamie Almquist, who served that church prior to coming to Good Shepherd, with us here today. Heidi and I and our one-year-old son at that time were moving to Wisconsin. I was ordained at my home church on November 30th, 1986. Raise your hand if you were there that day. Daniel was. Yeah. And you would have remembered the bishop presiding at my ordination. It was a cousin of my father's, Bishop Warren Soderman. He was a little confused in the service. And in the old Wren hymnal, right before the ordination service, is the confirmation liturgy. He used most of the confirmation liturgy. And then he said, I'm on the wrong page here. And the ordination continued, although some think I wasn't really ordained. I was installed at Glenwood Moravian Church, my first calling, on December 7th, 1986, and I said it with a tongue in cheek, a day that will live in infamy. Bad humor. In 1990, I was called to serve the Heimtal Moravian Church as well to assess and seek to establish a new congregation in the southwest area of Edmonton. And following 2 years of that service and ministry, it was acknowledged the assessment would conclude and I was called to the Bruderheim Moravian Church, where I served for 4 years. There in 1995, I received the call to come to Christ Moravian Church. I was installed here January 14th, 1996. Raise your hand if you're here at my installation service. Back then, you know, it's wonderful to see. Is my preaching any better? Quite a journey, huh? And your journey is a similar way and a different experience of life and faith and discovery of who God is calling you or each of us to be. May the words of my mouth, the meditations of all of our hearts and spirits be well-pleasing in God's sight. It's an understatement to say that I'm filled with really mixed emotions today, such gratitude, thanks, appreciation, recognizing the Spirit of God unconditionally, perpetually offering grace and love, forgiveness in my journey, my experience of life. The chance to share in ministry and mission service through the Moravian Church's life has been a true, true privilege. I'm humbled in so many ways at the experience to meet you and a whole choir of other folks that have experienced the joy of life alongside of me. Additionally, there's bewilderment that these 37 years of life seem to have flown by so rapidly. Does that happen to you too? Yeah. We're reminded that life's precious gift dare not be squandered, dare not be wasted in any way. Each day is precious, as today is. I do look forward to the next chapters of my life. My brother Keith, sisters Kai and Melanie would recall that our farmer philosopher father often said he was going to write a book someday. And as a calamity, a crisis would occur, he said, "That'll be an interesting chapter." And I covenant with you to write some chapters of good news in my life experience beyond today and into the future as God provides. And I trust and I covenant you keep writing good chapters of life and love in your experience too. Two scripture texts speak to our lives, our times, our faith experience, and not solely in this retirement vein of things occurring to me, but the bigger, broader recognition of Christ. As Ben said, initiating a new creation as the old passes away and the undiscovered facets of our relationship with God begin to be made new. They find new dimensions. They're given a new substance, a new style. That reading from the book of Corinthians, Ben, you got a great voice. Yeah. And they generate ideas for each of us, recognizing the encouragement we have to be reconciling in a broken world in all we can do, renewing, restoring where we go. We live in such divided, anxious, cautious times. What Paul called the church in Corinth to be about, we are called to be about as well. This past Christmas season, again, has reminded me, I think reminded all of us, of those ways in which our world is fragmented and divided, and it's calling us to be difference makers with reconciliation. As well, that reading from Ecclesiastes, we find insights for our lives, insights for our days, insights for our times, insights for our steps going forward. We know these phrases so well. As Marty highlighted with that song, we live it, turning, turning, turning. I've spoken on this reading countless, countless times. Sunday messages, at Camp Vesper gatherings, weddings, of course, funerals, laying to rest the dear ones whose time is now receiving the love God offers into death. These words speak to our lives, they speak to our days, they speak to our times. And on this day, it's such a perfect reading to guide some of our prayerful thoughts, I do believe. There's a time for everything, a season for every activity under heaven. This is what we call a truism, a truism. Truth and understanding simply flowing from those words. There is a time for everything as we've come to recognize. A time to be born. Even though I was there, I don't remember being born. Do you? Anybody? Now with video cameras, a young infant years later would experience, oh, I remember being born because I watched that in the birthing suite with mom, but I don't remember my birth. I don't remember being named either, as Alvin and Sylvia conjured up who this little infant would be and naming me Stephen Arnold Gotis. There are many years I didn't like my name, didn't like it for whatever reason. I had to grow into the understanding and the embrace of that full identity of who God would create in being Stephen Arnold Gotis. Yeah. Had to grow into it, discover that identity, that naming of us. It took time, it took those steps. Some 30 years ago, started doing this thing, coming back from a conference, a retreat, coming back from camp, some experience in which you had to put on the name taggy thing. I came back and I'd put that name tag badgy thing onto a peg in my office. That's a collection of a bit of my identity, and being named Stephen Arnold Gotis had to grow into it by those experiences found in all those circumstances, situations, and some, you know, didn't include a name tag. They included a coffee visit with you, a time to share and a few tears over a circumstance occurring. Those name tags need to be a part of my peg as well. Our lives take shape through our experiences, our events, activities, discoveries. We grow, we change, we mature, and the child we were born as gets named and we develop into who we become. And I can say that Gloria Taylor presented me with a new badge, officially retired. For my peg. The miracle of birth and beyond. God names us and we're called God's beloved children. It grows into our souls. And then we will be called home in knowing there is a time to be born and there's a time to die. As most of you know, I realize that my sense of humor is deeply embedded in me. I'm grateful for the times I get to laugh. I realize they're intimately connected to the times I'm privileged to weep. They go together, laughing and weeping. They hold hands in our hearts. The loving bond we have and laughing gives us permission then to weep and mourn in the privilege of being those we love as that experience occurs. I thank my family for being the intimate ones in my life, close to me, as the laughter filled houses and picnics, gatherings, and the tears did as well. Knowing my weird sense of humor, can you imagine the nonsense that Heidi has had to put up with for 41 years? 41 years. You all realize you get the best of me. Imagine what she gets day after day after day. Pray for her. Our families are so precious in life, aren't they, huh? Touched by the siblings I have, you've met them already. Precious in the precious love we find, the goodness found in the bonds and the ties that are developed. As I married Heidi, I recognized in this bond, new things would be discovered. And one of the things I realized very soon, I became a Jensen as she became a Godis. Our lines of heritage would be connected, bonded together. I became a Jensen and a part of the Jensen family, her parents, her three brothers, very wonderfully supportive for who we have become as folks. Every pastor, and I knew that this family, the Jensens, sort of loved me by the stuff that started occurring. Every pastor has an office or a study, and on that study door, you have some communication devices, communication tools that assist in your comings and goings and experiences. Very soon after my ordination, her brother Jim presented me with a wonderful Christmas gift for my office door. The pastor is, and you know the easy ones, the pastor is in. The pastor is out. The pastor is eating Oreos. The pastor is Elvis Presley. The pastor is not listening. They get better. The pastor is heavily sedated. The pastor is losing his grip on reality. For my dear friends in the stewardship and finance committee, the pastor is embezzling church funds. Last, but not least, spreading gossip about you. And 26 years ago, on my birthday, and I know who did this, my son added a new one. My 40th birthday. A 40-year-old coot eating birthday cake. To say the least, our lives get richer in the moments that we can laugh with one another, uplifted by one another. We get comforted by one another. As we all know, there will be times in which we're called then to weep with and console and love each other as tears roll down our cheeks. A time to laugh and a time to mourn. So many of Ecclesiastes' truisms in life stand out on this day. Time to plant. CMC will be planting with new seeds into the future, I trust and I know in my heart of hearts. This congregation is rich with gifts and love to be shared with this community and beyond. As we step into tomorrow with grace and steadfastness, God unfolds these things. Dear friends, it is time. Time for my retirement. Time for fresh ministry experiences at Christ Moravian Church and other pastoral support that will be gained in your experience. God's peace unfolding to you, each of you, I pray. And all God's people said, as shared earlier, I want to invite my colleague, my friend, Jamie Olmquist, offering the pastoral prayer.
Good morning, or good morning. Almost afternoon now. It's an honor to be here to help you all celebrate with Pastor Steve as he retires. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we've come together today to celebrate the ministry and the retirement of Pastor Steve Godis. But God, we are here today for so much more than celebrating the conclusion of Pastor Steve's ministry at Christ Moravian Church. This might feel like an ending, but just as the dormancy of winter gives way to springtime renewal and new beginnings, we know that the conclusion of one season does not mean another season isn't just around the corner. Pastor Steve has been a beloved leader and spiritual guide for the members of this church, for his colleagues, and for the surrounding community for many years. We thank you, God, for the skills and talents you gave Steve for carrying out the work that you called him to do. Through trials and challenges, your eternal presence strengthened and comforted him. In the dry seasons, you provided him with living waters to restore his soul. Your love and support gave him the courage he needed to make the love of Jesus Christ a reality for those around him. As he moves into this new season of his life and his ministry, may your unseen hand continue to guide him toward life-giving opportunities for joy. God, we also recognize that with Steve's transition to a new season in his life, Christ Moravian Church is also transitioning to a new season in the life of the community. So we pray for the Christ Moravian community as well. May your guidance and wisdom help this community to nurture and grow the seeds that Steve has planted. This is a new season, and the seeds planted in the season that is ending are ready to be nurtured for growth. The conclusion of this season is not the end. It is a new beginning. So God, we ask that you help this community to cultivate the seeds in this new season with hope, courage, and strength to move forward in positive and hopeful ways. You have presented the congregation with an opportunity for mutual exploration, learning, and growth. So open hearts and minds to explore, to learn, and to grow with grace, kindness, and compassion toward one another. It may not be easy at first, but it is necessary. And we pray that by working together in loving and supportive ways, Christ Moravian Church will continue your work in the life of this congregation and in the wider community. With hope, we pray all of this in your name. Amen.
Our lives, His grace, one.
have a seat. Just a few, we'll make them brief announcements. I know the deal with the time here. I was going to give this sermon timer to one of you to cut off that sermon. I forgot to do that. I know who I wouldn't have given it to. Thank you to all behind the scenes and before the scenes assistants making today a time of worship and gathering of God's people in a very holy and sacred way. Thank you. A special thanks to the folks that have come from afar taking part today. Go home safely. Our parking lot is way safer today with a little bit of snow than it was the ice skating rink on Saturday. So be safe out there going back home. As we conclude our worship service, what's transpiring, following a song of blessing, a brief postlude as I transition here, we'll move into a time of reflection and a program seated right here before the luncheon. So you'll stay seated, might be able to get up and move around if you wish during the postlude time. The elders, the executive board have planned this little program. Make it short and make it kind, please. Following that, the program, the Women's Fellowship have a luncheon downstairs, and things will get crowded and cozy, and at that juncture, you might want to come up here to have your sandwich and your cake up here. Two additional notes. Announced several weeks ago that Christ Moravian Church is blessed to welcome interim pastor Reverend Michael Ward. Who will be leading worship next Sunday, and you have to be here. We're bringing him out of retirement to do this. And I thought, this is funny. Lastly, mark your calendars for Friday, February 9th. Dust off your dancing shoes. CMC Fellowship Committee is hosting a Valentine's Day karaoke dance party. Tickets will be available next week. So February 9th is the karaoke dance Valentine's party. Words of benediction, words of blessing, good words for good people doing good ministry. One of my favorites, Apostle Paul. Encourage the faint-hearted. Help the weak. Be patient with all. Seek to do good. Rejoice always. Pray. Give thanks in all circumstances. And so may the God of peace sanctify you fully, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept well till the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Go in peace this day, dear friends. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Amen.
There's a dawn arising on a brand new day. There's a wind a-stirring across the ancient graves. There's a voice that's calling, would you be set free? There's a change a-coming, let it start in me. Let it start in me. Let it start in me. There's a change coming. Let it start in me. There's a fire that's burning sweeping across this land. There is heat consuming every evil plan. There is gold emerging from refining flame. There's a diamond sparkling where there once was shame. Let it start in me. Let it start in me. There's a change a-coming. Let it start in me. There's a storm a-brewing. There's a sound of rain. There's a thunder rumbling across an ancient grave. Let the drought be over if we just believe that the rains are coming. Let it rain on me. Let it start in me. Let it start in me. There's a change a-coming. Let it start in me. Let it start in me. Let it start in me. There's a change a-coming. Let it start in me. Thank you.